Hello all, I'm Viru from electronicsinnovation.com. Together, let's innovate the future. In this video, we will see how to connect ESP32 to UV.C using MicroPython over MQTT with Visual Studio Code. First, we'll set up ESP32 DevKit C board with MicroPython using ESP IDF. Then we will install Visual Studio Code and Node.js. Also, we will install the PyMaker plugin or extension in Visual Studio Code. Finally, we will write a script to connect ESP32 to UV.C over MQTT using MicroPython. Then I will test and demonstrate the same. Before jumping into the episode, let me thank my favorite PCB manufacturer, PCBWay.com, for sponsoring this video. PCBWay.com is one of the best PCB manufacturers in the current industry. PCBWay.com is offering services like PCB prototype, SMD stencil, PCB assembly, flexible PCBs and advanced PCBs. At PCBWay.com, we can get 10 pieces of 2-layer PCBs at just $5 with 24 hours build time. The best part of the PCBWay.com is the instant quote feature. Just enter the PCB size, choose quantity, layers and thickness. That's it. We will get the instant quote. Place an order by clicking on Save to Cart. Hardware and software requirements are as follows. Don't worry about software requirements. We will set up all of the software requirements soon in this video. First of all, go to Google and visit electronicsinnovation.com. Then open an article named Connect ESP32 to UV.C using MicroPython over MQTT with Visual Studio Code. In this tutorial, we will be required to download some packages and software. The links for all the downloads are provided here. That is the main reason you should open it. Scroll down, here you can see the steps involved in this procedure. There are 4 main steps involved. 1. Setting up ESP32 board with MicroPython. 2. Installing Visual Studio Code with PyMaker plugin. 3. Coding and uploading program to the ESP32. 4. Demonstration. Let's set up the ESP32 with MicroPython. Click on this link and download the Windows ESP IDF offline installer. This is a huge file. It takes some time based on your network bandwidth. After downloading, run this file as administrator. Accept the agreement and click on Next. Then select the latest version. Choose suitable directory. Keep all settings default and install it. Don't make any changes here. This installation process will take some time. Please be patient. Don't abort or close the installation window. After installation, click on Finish. Come back to the website and download the latest MicroPython firmware for ESP32 module using this link. This link will take you to the MicroPython official website. On this website, you can find the various board firmware and a lot of information about MicroPython. Click on generic ESP32 module and download the latest firmware binary file. After downloading, come back to the desktop and run ESP IDF command prompt. As you can see here, directory is set to desktop/ESP IDF. So, copy or move the freshly downloaded firmware file into the ESP IDF folder. Now connect ESP32 with laptop using micro ESP cable. Then copy the command from the website to erase the previous firmware of ESP32 and paste it into the command prompt. Hit the enter button to execute the command. This action will erase the flash memory of the ESP32. Now copy another command from the website and paste it here. Before hitting the enter button, make sure you have edited the command with the right file name. Otherwise, you will encounter an error. Then hit the enter button. This action will upload the new MicroPython firmware to the ESP32 module. That's it. The first step is completed. Let's move to the second step. Installing Visual Studio Code with PyMaker plugin. Download the Visual Studio Code setup file and Node.js file using the following links as shown here. Then install the Node.js package as shown here. Keep all settings default. After installation of the Node.js package, click on Finish button. Now install the Visual Studio Code. Accept the agreement. Choose a suitable directory for installation. Check the option to create a desktop icon. This will help us to launch the software quickly, then install it. After installation of the Visual Studio Code software, click on the Finish button. If you opt for Launch Visual Studio Code, it will automatically launch. Otherwise, launch the software manually. Navigate to the extension page using the fifth button in the left navigation. Search for PyMaker and install it. That's it. You have successfully installed the PyMaker extension for VS Code. Let's move to the next part. Coding and uploading program to the ESP32. Come back to the desktop and create a new folder and name it as ESP32_UBDOTS and save it. Now go to the VS Code and open the same folder from the file menu. We will use the MQTT protocol as the communication medium between ESP32 and UBDOTS Cloud. So, we should set up the MQTT libraries. First, add folders to hold the libraries. Click the new folder option and assign lib as the name. Again, click new folder and assign the name UMQTT. Now click on the new file and assign the name simple.py. Copy the code from the MicroPython simple.py repository using this link. Then paste it into the simple.py file and save it as shown here. Next, repeat these instructions but with robots.py as the file name. Copy the MicroPython library repository using this link and paste it into the robots.py file and save it. Right-click on the folder ESP32_UBDOTS and select a new file and assign it name boot.py. Then copy the code from the website and paste it here. Then save it. You can copy the code from the website in two ways. Select total code and hold Ctrl+C button, or simply click this button to copy the code to the clipboard. Then again click on the folder ESP32_UBDOTS and select new file and assign main.py as the file name. Then copy this code from the website and paste it into the main.py file and save it. You have successfully imported the total code to the VS Code project, but don't upload the code yet. We need to make some changes to work with your device. Open boot.py and enter SSID and password of the available Wi-Fi network and then save it. Then open the main.py and enter the UBDOTS token. You can get this unique UBDOTS token from the UBDOTS account itself. Copy and paste the UBDOTS token as shown here. Enter the client ID. This can be anything in combination of random alphanumeric name or device ID. For testing and demonstration purposes, we are posting the latitude and longitude of the device and the status of the pin 13. You can enter your device's latitude and longitude to see the location on the UBDOTS as shown here. After all changes are done, save the script. Now it's time to upload code to the ESP32 module. Connect the ESP32 module to the computer with the help of micro USB cable and make sure the PyMaker plugin is activated. If everything okay on terminal, you will see a similar kind of text. These three greater than symbols represents that this ESP32 is ready to execute the instructions. Now, click on the upload button as shown here. This action will upload all four files present in the project to ESP32 module. Once the whole project has been uploaded to the ESP32, the module will get reset and run automatically. At the next moment, you can see the log on the PyMaker terminal stating that the data is being sent to the UBDOTS. Now the third part is completed successfully. Next, move to the final and interesting part of the episode, demonstration. Go to your UBDOTS account, then check the devices section. You will see a newly created device named ESP32_EI. This is the beautiful part of the UBDOTS. UBDOTS will automatically create a device for us whenever the new data packet is received. These are the devices I have created previously for other projects. If you go into the newly created device, you can see the example data that we have just sent to UBDOTS. We can visualize the same data on the UBDOTS as shown here. Beautiful, right? If you wanted to post any other sensors data, all you have to do is to make an appropriate changes in this part of the code and upload to the ESP32 module. Newly published data can be visualized as shown here. If you wanted to make an exercise project with ESP32, MicroPython and UBDOTS, you can check out the above I button. That's all for the tutorial, connect ESP32 to UBDOTS using MicroPython over MQTT with Visual Studio Code. I hope you have learned something new from this episode. See you soon on the next interesting episode. Bye bye.